Hello, NIS learners. This is Senior Secondary course Physical Education and Yoga. In this course, we are talking today on school health programs. According to WHO, an effective school health program can be one of the most cost-effective investments a nation can have to simultaneously improve education and health. There are three main things we must understand to cover in any school health program. Number one, school health services. Number two, school health environment. Number three, school health education. So you will find school health is common, but services, environment and education. We'll talk each of it in detail. Let us first talk about school health services. This has been designed under National Health Mission. Number one, National Mass Deworming. How? By giving albendazole tablets and iron tablets. These specific tablets are given periodically to the children so that the whatever is there, worms in their body or particularly in the stomach, so they can be out. Iron tablets work there to get rid of anemia, because in our country there are a lot of children who are anemic. So these are some of the things National Health Mission has initiated. Second is periodical medical examination. This is done by the class teacher or medical experts time to time, and they observe the clinical signs of the body of school age children. Further, if there are any serious things, then remedial measures are used in the follow-up, first aid treatment or referral services for further treatment. Next is collection of records are kept at schools for each child about any communicable disease, immunization, etc. Regular counseling is also done and should be done about career aspects, juvenile delinquency, drug addiction, so that more complexity does not occur in that age, because that age is kind of establishment for the future. Nutritional services, that means one must be guided, or children must be guided and provided with the midday meal programs are available throughout the country in various aspects with local available fresh foods available in this program. This is the picture how school children are taking the midday meal. Next service which school provides is first aid. In case of emergencies, first aid box should be available in the school, and some kind of ambulance services link should be available. So whenever any emergency or any happening happens in the school, can be handled immediately. Dental examinations are new thing in schools, because a lot of guidance and reference services are needed. Health education. Though the health world itself is a very big, but this requires constant counseling. Sometime it is a part of the curriculum, and sometime in some schools, small projects are given to the children to work at home. In this, they learn how to keep their body healthy. Health records are also kept with their name, date of birth, parents' name, address, health history, and also the doctors whom to contact when needed. This is very much required with the children who has some kind of chronic problem, maybe the type 1 disease, maybe other kind of problem, so that, or many kind of allergy, so that the other school staff can remember those things and child may not get hurt. Second point, we are talking about the school health environment. When we are talking about the environment, it directly relates with the sanitation, hygiene, and drinking water. For that, we must provide in every school adequate sanitation, hygienic environment, or we can say the clean environment in the school premises, availability of safe drinking water for the children, and time to time nutrition education is also given directly or by the experts or by adding some points in the curriculum. As I told you, proper execution of midday meal program is also required. Location of a school is very important, because if it is centrally situated where the approach road is common, it is a fair distance, and the marketplace is also common or nearby, then whenever needed, some kind of things when needed can be approached or managed well. You may think that what is the relation of health environment and the furniture? It is very much related. So the classroom size, particularly the furniture, should be suited to the age group of the students. When the school has small children around 6 years, 7 years, 5 years, 4 years, then the furniture should be that much of height so that the child can sit very easily. You cannot provide the child for study when his or her legs are hanging in air. Periodical health examination of the children is required. It is also required to make the separate toilets for girls and boys, so that the privacy and safety of the girls can be maintained in school. Other features of organizing school health programs include health council and health committee should be constituted in each school. And this health committee should take lead in conducting the school health program. As and when every school has some or the other kind of committees for various kinds of activities in the school, simply in the same way, health committee is also required and will be responsible for health of the school children. What they will look into it? Keeping the school free from violence or any other kind of destruction. No corporal punishments should be given to the children, and if it is added, the regular practice of yoga, physical education and health education, it will be very good for the not only the physical health of the children, but it will definitely improve the academic records of the children also, and it will also boost the self-confidence in children. First aid room or the first aid kit should also be maintained so that at the time of need it can be available. Health education. What will be included in the health education? Teaching various aspects of health and safety. This is very much required in current time. In variety of ways you can teach, from starting with the brushing your teeth so that dental care can easily be maintained, personal hygiene, community hygiene, how to take care of the body, all these things can be included, and you must also provide some kind of knowledge for the safety purpose. So The training of personal hygiene, environmental health and the family life is also added in the health education. Medical history of this individual child, if it is present in the record, can easily be traced whenever needed. Regular dental checkup, and if there is a problem with the child for any other chronic problem, referral services for emergencies and special problem can be managed and arranged to send the child for the treatment. Foundation of support of every child and adolescent is established in that age if a school provides some kind of environment that will lead throughout their life and will be more helpful to the children. Well implemented health education improves the school achievements. As I told you just now, it is not only the physical health, but if physical health is good, it will improve the mental health also, then school achievements will be better always. Allow the children to actively participate in various kinds of games, plays and other extracurricular activities also, where the children are physically involved. Daily morning inspection of each child in order to know the signs of illness may be very, very helpful. Some schools still do all these activities in the morning. Health of the school children is the main responsibility of the parents, teachers, stakeholders, health administrators, and the community. You can see here, so child is small, he is not self-reliant enough to take care of his own health or her own health, then the parents should take care of it. Further, teachers, stakeholder, health administrator and the community is also equally responsible for health of the children in the society. That is why the school health committee, if set up by the government in 1960, they are recommended to have such kind of committee so that the integral part of the general health services can take care very easily. In each school, health councils and health committee should be constituted and it should take lead in conducting the health programs. Who can be the members of the school health committee? Many people can add on it, for whom we can include them: school medical advisor, health coordinators, various teachers, students themselves, parents, representatives from school management, counselors, trained teachers of first aid, nutritionists and dentists. Most of the people can be collected in a committee or put in the committee from the school itself, but if somebody from outside also will also add value to their committee. What they will do? They will manage the need-based medical care. In that, medical advisor or doctor should be available fully or part-time. As I said, whenever needed, all these resources should be available to the school. In that, school health committee will be very helpful. So, health coordinator is responsible person for implementation of all these such activities in school health programs. He or she can be the head of the department, principal or physical educationist. In this video, you have learned the main three things we have talked about: school health education, school health environment and school health services. Hope you have understood the lesson very well and those who are studying and doing the work in a school will be helpful, and they must establish some kind of our health services in their own schools. Thank you very much.